Okay, so here's my video on cable management as promised. It quite possibly is one of the most boring topics on the planet, and very hard to describe because you have to create orderly chaos. So I'll just give you a little close-up of what I've done on the back of my Cooler Master here, or the side back panel. So I've got that, the 8-pin power connector from the motherboard going right up the corner there, and some fan cables coming down, and just keeping everything as flat as possible so nothing's getting squeezed against the panel when it goes back on. And I've got the big power supply going right up there and then curling around. And just using those cable ties to keep everything bunched together, sort of like braiding everything together. Just like that. I think when you're doing this cable management, just take it slowly, don't be in a rush. Don't get frustrated, because some of those cables need to be secured quite well, otherwise you could end up damaging the motherboard, and that is mainly in regards to the SATA cables, because some of them are quite stiff, and if you have too much tension on them, you're going to probably rip the connector out of the motherboard, which is not good. So anyway, that's the back of my case. Now I'll show you the see-through side. Okay, so here's the proper interior of my case. Something I didn't show in the computer build. Oops, gone out of focus. Is those USB connectors. So that's this one here on the Zeus board. Whoops. This one here is the USB 1 for the front panel. This one here, USB 2, is the one I've used for the card reader. And then I've got a spare one here that I haven't used. Over here, that was the audio cables. Now you can see now, I remember on the build we had a huge bunch of cables. Now it's been reduced to, I've got them, all the cables I've got popping out of the motherboard, I haven't got any hard angles on the wires. I've pulled them out and done on every cable, I've got it like a U shape. So there's no tension on the cable. It just comes out. And then what I do is I put a cable tie down at the bottom of my U bent. Okay. So it's fixed there. And then you've got connection. So it's all loose in between. And it's just nice and soft. What else? Where are we here? Oops, hang on. On the power cable for the graphics card here, once again, instead of bending the cable really sharply, I've just built a really nice gentle curve going back out the back, down behind what we can't see, and then coming back in through this bottom hole here back into the power supply. So just about every cable goes out the back and then comes back in somewhere. What else have we got here I can show you? I've got some fan cables here. Got some of them attached to the one of the tubing for the water cooler. Pretty boring stuff, isn't it? There's the power and data cable for the DVD drive. What more can I say? That's about it. The only other thing you may be interested in, which I forgot to mention, is I bought an NZXT LED lighting kit, and that's what you can see here. It's got the braiding around the cable, and it also comes with these great little adhesive clips that you can use to fix it to the case, so that was quite good. So that's basically it. Yeah, what more can I say? One thing I will do, I will make another little video quite soon explaining what I've learnt about the fan management on the ASUS motherboards, because if you look on the internet, there's a lot of confusion about which connectors do what and how you set it up with which particular fans. So you can, because I've got all my fans running off the motherboard except for the front intake fan on the case, and I'm successfully using the fan assistant in the ASUS suite to control the speed of the fans. So in relation to when the CPU heats up, the fans turn up, and when the CPU cools down, they power back down. So I'm really, really happy with the results. So anyway, there's cable management. Really is something that you can only work out yourself, because no two cases are really going to be the same. So thanks again for watching, thanks for listening, and I'll see you next time.